find it hard to keep or have a marriage relationship. Do you experience delays or disappointments in marriage? Does it seem your beauty or handsomeness is massive? How long have you been waiting for the fruit of the womb? How many miscarriages have you experienced? Is your life, your career, and your family going through a circle of stagnation and misfortune? Could it be a spirit husband or spirit wife is involved? Stay tuned to this teaching from God's Oracle, Reverend Gabriel Grant, and your deliverance.
You. Welcome back. Let us enter into the effects of these spirit husbands and spirit wives. The effects. With believers, I want to start off with those who are born again, children of God, who are going through this experience. When you have sex in the dream, when you have a spirit husband and spirit wife, and you're having the sex in the dream, it siphons the power of God and the presence of God. Sometimes when you get all your senses dry, it also produces lust. Lots of people who had this experience, after 1-2 days, they started having sexual lust for over one person, or sometimes over more than two persons, and they can't understand how it came about. Yes, it is the effects of sexual dreams, having spirit husbands and spirit wives. Late marriage is also one of the effects of having spirit husbands or spirit wives, both men and women. I know of men, let me begin with the men. I know of men who have late marriage. They can only make love with a girl, but they cannot marry the girl. They don't have a problem medically. They are growing older, but they can't have a wife in the house. He's into his 50s and he's still talking about the day I'm going to get married. My brother, I begin to fear that you have a spirit wife. I'm sorry, but that may be the truth behind your marriage delays, and you need to war against it. I know of a girl. This lady, she's from of the Manyu origin. She's of the Manyu origin, Manfe in Cameroon. This lady told me herself, the pastor don't know what's going wrong with me. The first time a man met me, we discussed about marriage, reaching somewhere, I preached the marriage. The second time, I started building another relationship until a point we went to the village. We reached at the village, or on the road to the village, I created a problem. And we could not understand, and so we went there, just deposited the things and came back, and that's how it folded up. The third one, and this one was sure, we reached my village and we entered the house, and while they were giving, in our culture they used to give wine, you hold the wine or the soft drink and you show who's your husband, you give him to drink. I took mine and I drank it all and told them I don't have my husband here, and he was so embarrassed, and that's how it ended. But when I came back, I was crying and weeping, what is the problem? Until my family had to give up on me and said, okay, they can't take anything on my from me on my behalf, because they are not sure and guaranteed that I'll get married to the man. This was the force of a spirit husband. With some men, they don't have a wife in the house. And even if they have a wife in their house, because of the spirit wife that they have, the demonic wife that they have, each time that demonic wife in her jealousy will stir the man up, he will beat this woman almost to death. And after he comes back to his senses, he's regretting. Why? Because there is a spirit wife that is a rival. I heard a man told me, he said, Each time I look at my wife, sometimes I see her beautiful. And he was talking to a beautiful wife. I knew the wife. Wife was beautiful. But he said, each time I look at my wife, I see she looks so old and cranky. Then I told him, I said, two things are on ground. Either your wife has a spirit husband that masks her beauty before you, or you have a spirit wife that masks her beauty so that you can send your wife away, your real wife, and let the spirit wife have access over your life. If that is your case, you look at your wife, she's beautiful, but out of the blue, somehow, some days, not because she offended you, something just came over you and you are looking at your wife very ugly and everything she says irritates you. Man, I'm afraid you might be having a spirit wife and you need deliverance, and God is going to deliver you in the name of Jesus. Sometimes the effects of this spirit husbands and spirit wife, this sex in the dream, is misfortune after the sex dream. You just had sex in the dream. Each time your business wants to succeed, you want to go in for a business turn. The night you had sex in the dream, you just discovered everything folded up. You went misfortune left and right, money lossage left and right. It's because these demons are at work. Sterility and impotence is one of the effects. Most women who have spirit husbands hardly have children. Because why? They have children in the realm of the spirit, have children in the spirit world. Each time, as I said, she takes in, then she just discovered she was carrying a baby. Or each time she wants to take in, she discovers she was carrying a baby in her dreams. Some discover they have about 3 children, 4, 5 children walking around them in their dreams. But in the physical, they have no child. It brings sterility. With men, it brings impotence. When you continually have sexual dreams, before you know, you're reading low sperm count and other complexities, you can't impregnate a woman. Some other women develop what I call phantom pregnancy. I remember by prophecy or by revelation, God revealed me to a woman and said, go to this church, this man of God is going to pray for you, because she was 1 year, 1 month pregnant. And it wasn't pregnancy, it was a phantom pregnancy. And she had gone to the hospital, some results are read is a baby. Other results read it's not a baby, it's a mass of growth. And whatsoever, there was confusion. Sometimes she feels the baby kicking in her womb. And at one prophetic night, a word was released, a power of God came upon her, slapped off that mess. She excreted satanic stuff that had been in her stomach for 1 year, 1 month. Oh, praise the Lord for setting her free. I remember we ministered to another girl who said she was 6 months pregnant, and it was still this phantom pregnancy. They go to the hospital, it develops like normal baby. They will go to the hospital, they see nothing. And in that meeting, the power of God came upon her. She landed under the anointing, got up, the stomach descended to normal. Praise the Lord, God set her free. Yes, it used to occur. Others, this spirit used to attack the ovulation period of a woman. When a lady having a spirit husband is coming to her ovulation period, at the time of what is usually called unsafe period, the night of her unsafe period, some few things happen, some few discover a satanic manipulation. Either the husband traveled, or that demon just tells her, she created problem with the husband that they could not meet that particular night. And when the night is over, then she begins to expect. She normalizes her problem, a marital crisis. Each time they're close to her ovulation period, there is always a problem in the family. That is satanic manipulation. These are the effects of spirit husband. Is that your case? Then you need deliverance. They cause abstinence from sex. I remember a lady came and met me and said, my husband is promiscuous. Pray, man of God. My husband jumps out left and right, does not stay in the house. And while I held hands in prayer, as the Holy Ghost witnessed to me, he said, it is the spirit husband of this woman that is pushing this man out with other women so that he can have access to this woman in the house. Oh, I told her, asked her some experience she used to have in her dreams and in her life. She said yes, which were sure signs that she had a spirit husband. Then I told her, I said, your spirit husband, each time he wants to come, pushes your husband outside, creates a problem, and your husband will abandon the house for you. And that night when your husband goes out, you will have wet dreams. She said yes. Yeah, those are the effects of spirit husband. Vice versa, sometimes he pushes some women outside just to make the man to have a monopoly over the man. But God is going to set you free in the name of Jesus. So some of these extramarital affairs you experience with men are the effects of spirit husbands and spirit wives. Others kill their rivals. Other spirit husbands kill the rival husband. Let's read something in the book of Matthew, chapter 22. There's a story there. Verse 25. There's a story there. I know it's a story of a spirit husband. Now, there were with us seven brothers. The first died after he had married and having no offspring, left his wife to his brother. Likewise, the second also, and the third, even to the seventh. Last of all, the woman died also. This is a story. It was not just a parable. They said there was, which means it was a true story. A man got married to a woman. The first sign of a spirit husband was that the woman had no child. The second sign of a spirit husband is that the man died leaving the woman. And according to Hebrew custom, the second man, the brother, had to inherit the wife of the deceased and raise up children. Might be the brother had children with his own wife, but the moment he got married to this woman, it's not like he died immediately. They had union together, but he could not produce for this woman because there was a spirit husband in the life of this woman that was stopping him from having a child, and the spirit husband ended up killing him. To the third brother, to the fourth brother, to the sixth brother. It is not coincidence for seven men to marry a woman and they could not raise a child from that woman, and all of them died leaving this woman. This woman had a strong spirit husband that was killing his rivals. I have a family issue. One of my family members, she's been married. I think she got married to almost a fourth man, and the fourth man died. The first man she got married to raise children, the man died. She got married to the second man, raised children, the man died. Got married to the third one, raised children, the man died. Got married to the fourth one. Oh no, these are the works of spirit husbands. They kill their rivals. Sometimes, vice versa, if it happens to a man, there are some men who get married to a woman. The spirit wife kills the wife. He goes and gets married to another woman again. The spirit wife kills that other woman. Now the family begins to accuse this man. Oh, you are in the occult. This man is dead. And the man is very innocent. He does not know anything about occultism. He weeps why a woman cannot stay in his house. Mr. Sir, are you listening to me? Brother, is that your situation? Yes, there is a God in heaven that sets free. I know you are innocent. I accept with you. Yes, but women don't stay in your house. Either they die or something strange happens and people are accusing you that you're a bloody man. Oh no, you need deliverance in the name of Jesus, and only Jesus can set you free.
The Lord becomes so strong upon you. This generation here, thank you again. This generation is not permitted to remain this. While you are there, look at me here. Look at me. Take it. Take it. Take it. Take it. Take it. Take it. Because it's a morning for supernatural. It's a morning for supernatural. It's a morning. Take it. It's a morning for supernatural. Take it now. Take it. Take it, all of you. Take it.
deliverance from spirit husbands and spirit wife. Number one, you need to surrender your life to Jesus. Christ said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. You can't have deliverance without Jesus. You need to say, Jesus, come into my heart. If you're a girl here, listen to me. In the book of Isaiah chapter 54, verse 6, he says, I am your husband. Christ is our spiritual husband, your true husband. And so any demonic spirit husband that claims right over you, when you surrender to Christ, a true spiritual husband, breaks the power of that demonic husband. So you need to be born again. You need to surrender your life to Christ, and you need to repent from that sexual sin. Total repentance is needed. You need a change. But I want to say, as I point you to deliverance, until these things, the occurrence of these things, they upset you. If you look at them to be normal occurrences, you remain where you are. You will never be delivered. You need deliverance. You need to believe that you need deliverance. You need to accept that you need deliverance. You need to be desperate for it, for you to be delivered. And it goes with repentance. You need to repent from every sexual immorality, every sexual life you ever carried out. Denounce. That is number two. You need to denounce. And I'm about in some few minutes to lead you in the denouncing prayers. What is denunciation? Break the covenant. Telling that spirit, you are no more. Party with me. In case you've been going through this demonic oppression, you've been going through this wickedness, and you know you need deliverance, you have repented, you've surrendered your life to Jesus, and you want to denounce that covenant, I want to pray with you. Oh yes, there's an anointing for deliverance this day. Today, Christ is assuring me to assure you that woman, that covenant is about to be broken. Man, that covenant is about to be broken right to the root of your generations, to your cousins, your sisters. I know families, the whole entire family, nobody's married, not even one, no one girl, no. Even the men are just like that, nobody gets married. Oh yes, today is the dawn of a new day. Can you, if you want to break that covenant with spirit husband and spirit wife, join me as we do this prayer of denunciation. Repeat after me. You can touch the screen as you repeat this prayer after me. Lord Jesus, I come in your name. I surrender my life to you. And I accept the blood of Jesus that pardons all my sins. From this day, I turn my life over to you. And I denounce, as I repent from every sin of sex I committed, every known sin my forefathers committed that got me into this wickedness, I repent from it and I denounce it. You spirit husband or spirit wife, from this day, I denounce that relationship. I break the covenant link, every covenant link with my blood, with the property of my body, every link that was gotten through sexual intercourse, I denounce and I break it in the name of Jesus. I am free. I separate my life, spirit, soul, and body. From this day, I am married to Jesus. I do not know you. And any child I made with you in the realm of the spirit, I slay by the sword of the spirit, and I come out free from your grip. I am free in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for setting me free. The covenant is broken in the name of Jesus. Amen. I want to pray with you. Stretch your hand, just keep your hands on that screen as I begin to attack those forces. There's an anointing so strong upon me. Hallelujah. Lebrondo kosondororobo shakandereba. Librudabalandororobo sindereba. As you lay your hands on that screen, as you stretch your hands towards that screen, get ready. The power of God, some of you, wherever you are, the power of God is going to hit, come upon you. And that devil, some of you, if you fall under the anointing, don't bother. That devil is about to check out. As you release your faith, I command that devil to get out. Hey, you spirit husband, leave that girl. You have affected her education, affected her life, affected her womb, affected the marriage of the mother and the entire family. Hey, I command you, go. In the name of Jesus, loose her. The power of God is so much upon you. You can sense the fire of God moving from the crown of your head to the sole of your feet. You can sense a strong anointing. That anointing is breaking the yoke of wickedness. Come and be loose. Some of you listening and watching me now, if you sense you're vomiting anything here, just release yourself. That's anointing of the Holy Ghost coming upon you. Some of you, your body will be vibrating. Every moving object in your system, the satanic poison, the poison into your system by a spirit husband, a spirit wife, is coming out now. It's coming out now. Out. In the name of Jesus, get out. Leave her alone. Leave that young man alone. Break out from the life of that young man. Hey, you devil. You are attacking the life of that fair girl. I see a fair girl under a satanic attack. Each time she sleeps, you mess up with her in the dream. She gets up weeping. I rebuke you. Get out of her. That moving object in the stomach of that lady, go. In the name of Jesus, go. Break. Yes. As the anointing comes upon you, even some of you that are falling under the anointing, right away, the power of God is moving in you. I release a fire of God to burn, to crush the powers of darkness. You are loose. I stand as a servant of God and I proclaim your liberty. I stand as a servant of God and I proclaim your liberty. I stand as a servant of God and I declare your freedom in the name of Jesus. You are free. That growth in your stomach has just disappeared. That movement on your chest has just disappeared. That low sperm count on that man has just gone in the name of Jesus. Check yourself. That phantom pregnancy is flushing out. That demonic stuff, some of you, watch your excreta, watch your urine, watch what goes out of you. You will discover just this as you watch this tape. Discover things are getting out of your life. God is setting you free, and you are free indeed. God bless you. In the name of Jesus, you are free. I want to thank you for watching this program. And once more, I am Reverend Gabiga Clement of the Full Gospel Church, Munyi Assembly. You are blessed to watch me over Eagle TV. There are numbers on the screen. Many of you have just received miracles, healings, deliverance. You've just received a touch from the Lord. Some of you fell under the anointing. Call the numbers on the screen. There are numbers on the screen. Get to our contact and we'll minister to you. We'll counsel you. Tell us your experience. We want to celebrate God with you. I prophesy over your life. You're getting married. I prophesy over your life. Your finances are being restored. I prophesy over your life. Things are changing because that devil, his power is broken. Remain strong in the Lord. Blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Jesus is Lord. Till I come your way again. See you. Be a fan of Eagle TV. Amen.